My name is Joanna Gell. We are at University of California, Los Angeles, and I work in the Amander Clark Lab, and I am a physician scientist. So I am focusing on a specific type of cancer called germ cell tumors. That's cancers that mostly affect sort of your reproductive organs, like the ovaries and the testes.
I am grabbing out my cells from the incubator, and they need their media, which is sort of their feed, to be changed every day.
I actually grew up on the other coast. I'm from the East Coast. I grew up just a little bit north of Boston in Massachusetts. My family is very like artistic, and artists and musicians and chefs and like all this sort of like hands-on artsy type stuff. And then there's me, the scientist. I grew up riding horses and being around a lot of animals. So actually that's sort of what piqued my interest in science. I wanted to be a vet when I was a little kid. So I knew I needed to like science and enjoy science to be a vet. So it started at a young age.
We have two mouse ones going, all of the human is down.
So right now I am doing mostly research instead of working with patients, and through looking at various models, so either at cells or tissues from actual cancers, I'm studying why maybe these cancers occur. One of the tools I use is I do what we call tissue culture or cell culture. So I have like individual plates of cells that I grow and look at, and we'll be working on sort of changing some of their gene properties or their genetic properties to hopefully make them almost like a germ cell, to sort of learn from that. So that's one area that I've been working on. And I was able to obtain some actual samples of germ cell tumors. They usually come sort of as like a little piece of the tumor is stuck onto a slide. And then the slide, you can look for different proteins by staining with specific things that we call antibodies to look at what they're expressing on these tumors. And then with that, there's various types of microscopes that you can use to analyze them and see, you know, what these tumors are expressing. So that's been one major part of my project, because that helps you learn about identifying the different types and seeing what's different from one type to the next type, or is there something different, whether it comes from the testes or if it's in the brain or in a different part of the body, are they the same or are they different? So that's one area that I do. It is a collaborative effort. We all have our own project that is what we focus on, but certainly everyone, you know, if you need help doing this or learning how to do a new technique and someone else knows how to do it, you know, they're always there to help you, as well as, you know, some projects sort of work more closely with other projects. So we have, you know, another person in our lab who works specifically with human cells, and because I'm working with a human disease specifically, you know, we focus together more. But as far as like learning different lab techniques or things like that, everyone kind of helps everyone out. So I was hoping that if you better understand why germ cell tumors occur, maybe you can find a specific protein or gene that you can sort of target and say, we can make therapy specifically against that and try to minimize how much damage we have from the chemotherapy or the radiation that we give to treat them. So I'm hoping to, you know, not have as much long-term side effects from the treatment, and in general have a better outcome if you get germ cell tumors. And so learning the sort of cellular biology helps us get better treatments in the long run.